Okay, three. Oh, five. Okay, eight. 10. 13. 25. But the enemy is wise. He said, let us do a wise you with them. Lest they catch on to what's going on with you. And if you're not careful, I don't want to become a Christian who hangs my heart on the
river.
Psalms 137:1 said, by the rivers of Babylon, there we sat down, yea, we wept. When we remembered Zion, we hanged our hearts upon the willows in the midst thereof. For there they that carry us away captive. Now listen to this. They took us captive, but they required us a song. And they that wasted us required of us mirth, saying, sing us one of the songs of Simon. And their response was, how shall we sing the Lord's song in a strange land? And if you're not careful as a Christian, I don't care if you've been in the church for 1 week or if you've been in the church for 6,000 weeks. Every person that goes through a fiery trial, you will be tempted to hang your heart on the willow. Because there is nothing more defaming than to put somebody through hell and tell them, now sing to us. To have somebody beat you to a bloody pulp. To have somebody poke you and inflict you and put you through hell day after day after day. And then that same thing shows up and says, you know, why don't you sing these songs of Zion? Isn't that just like the enemy?
Right.
Have we forgotten that the enemy is not our friend? He is not my lover. He is not my brother. Have the Church of the Living God forgotten that Satan is our adversary? He is our enemy. He is our foe of the faith. He's seeking whom he may devour. But I tell him tonight, you can't have your faith. You can't have my faith. Somebody, don't you hang your hearts on the middle? Fight the good fight of the Lord. And the Lord said, Simon, Simon, behold, Satan hath desired to have you, that he may sift you. You ever seen a sifter? My grandma had one. Is an old tin and you put it in, she'd squeeze that thing and sift through. Right. You've never been sifted. It's painful. But Satan said, I desire to have you that I might sift you like wheat. But he said, I pray for thee that thy faith fail thee not. Can I tell you, Satan's desire to sift you, but the Holy Ghost is praying for you. He said, hold on to your faith. Don't let Satan cause you to fail. You may see the end of the road. It may not be getting better, but I tell you, we've been endured only for a night. But joy comes in the morning. If you could just sing another song, if you could just clap your hands, if you could shout,
praise God. Praise God.
Shall be saved. And can I tell the Church of the Living And his teacher said, you mess up with me. Do you know where I am? You mess up with me, you mess up with my whole
family. Come on.
Oh, God. You see where you live. You don't need them. That's good. But where I come, we run together.
Right.
There's a travesty in the church that happens when you get isolated in your tribe. When you get isolated, Pastor, it'll pain you. Because once you're isolated, then nourishment comes. I know you just want to pull the covers in. You can't do that. So you're going to hang it up. I'm not going to sing anymore. Because you're hurt. Now I'm old school. I'm right at 50 years old. I'm old school. I don't fit into this generation. I don't get this generation sometimes. Because I did what the pillars of the church taught. You get in a gym, you take your pillow, your blankets, you get them kids, fill up them bottles, you get your formula, you get everything ready, and we're coming to the house of God, and we go pray until we get a breakthrough. I'm in the church of the living God, right? I know, Pastor and Sister Gloria, I don't believe that. But God forbid that we think we can do this on our own.
Come on.
No way.
No way.
See, you're not mean enough. But I am.
Come on, tell it.
And see, this is why when you and I join together, you can do things that I'm not good at. But I can cut somebody where you can't. And see, when we come together, we create a friction. We create something in the supernatural. And it's why God said, I don't want you to cut yourself off from me. I don't want you to cut yourself off from the church. I rebuke this spirit that tells you, don't pay your tithes no more. Don't go to church no more. Don't trust the church people no more. Don't sing another song. Don't go to outreach again. Don't run the aisle again. Don't do it again. I call the devil's bluff tonight. The devil is a liar. Now, so, Elder, if it happens to me, and it involves now the whole family, it's not just you fighting the world by yourself. I got your back. She's got his back. You got his back. You got his back. You got his back. She's got his back. And there was something that happens when we come together in numbers that absolutely disillusions the enemy. When you come together in praise, when you come together in fight, when you come together to blow the trumpet, when you come together to clap your hands, the mess of God comes down and it gives you room for a breakthrough. I felt the Holy Ghost pass out and hurt the world. I felt the Holy Ghost. Some of you have been fighting sickness. You've got them, they're not the spirit, you've got the flesh.